In the last video, we have worked a lot on products-related routes. In this one, I want to add a validation so that only valid data makes it into our database. The most interesting part for that is a post request in our API, where we create a new product, where we store a name and a price. And what happens if a user passes, let's say, a string as a price? Well, let's find out. Let's change the body of the post request, change the price to high, which doesn't look like a correct price. And if I send this, we get a new product, but with a zero price. This happens because we manually cast a price from the user input to float. But such behavior is confusing. The user has provided an invalid data, but we have silently persisted it. Also, if I don't provide the price at all, I still get back a valid response. Definitely that is not how it should work. Instead, our API should validate the user's input, and if the request is not valid, the user should receive a 400 bad request. So let's work on that. First of all, we need some validation rules. I don't want to reinvent the wheel here, and we'll use a package respect validation. Composer require respect validation. Okay, now open create product controller. Before persisting the data, we need to validate the input. Create a validator. The first one is for name. We are going to check that the request body contains a key name, and we provide a set of rules here. The name shouldn't be blank and should be a string. Set a name for our validator. It will be used to build error messages. Then create a validator for a price. We check that the value is not blank, numeric, and positive. And we name this validator as price. The whole request validator will be the combination of these two. Method assert validates the request body and throws an exception in case of invalid request. We can catch a nested validation exception here. For invalid request, we should return 400 response with error messages explaining what's wrong with the input. Let's add a constructor for it. Open JSON response and add a new static constructor bad request. It accepts an array of strings. Inside, return a response with status code 400 and an object with errors. Open the controller and return bad request response. Well, let's see how it works. Here I have a request with a missing price. Send it and I get back a response saying that I should provide a price. Nice. Now add a price, but let's send it as a string, something like that. Okay, we receive a list of errors saying that we should provide a numeric positive price. By the way, the same validation can be reused here in product update. Notice that we also extract price and name from the request body. I think that we are missing an abstraction here. A custom request on top of ReactPHP server request. Let's name it input. It is a wrapper, so via the constructor we inject a request. Class input will be responsible for user's input. It can validate itself. Copy validation logic from the controller. Paste it. Input namespaces. And fix request variable. And let's add helper methods for a name and for a price. Okay, I don't want to return response in validate method, because it requires additional checks in controllers. Instead, we let the exception to bubble up. Remember that we have our own error handler that catches all possible errors. Let's use it. Add one more catch block here for a nested validation exception. And inside the catch block, return a 400 response. Done. Now open the controller and instantiate input. Then call validate method. Here use helpers for a name and for a price. Well, looks much better. Let's check that it still works. Send a post request and we still get a 400 response with errors. Nice. Let's add validation to update product controller. Again, instantiate input, validate the request, and use helpers to extract a name and the price of the product. Done. Let's see that validation works. Go to put request, and let's remove the name and make price a string. Send it, and yes, we get a 400 response with nice error messages. But if I send a valid request with the correct name and price, then it succeeds. And with that, our API becomes more stable. Now we are sure that the data we do expect is valid.